Hi guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. Please don't forget to like, comment and subscribe. The Didinga people are known for their musical instruments such as drums and harps, which they play on special occasions like battle, hunting or dancing. They believe in the presence of a higher power and the realm of spirits that communicate with humans via gifts, prayers and offerings. One of their customary religious rites and belief is the presence of a tribal rainmaker who is charged with carrying out specific ceremonies in order to produce rain. Didinga also give sacrifices to the spirits and gods, worshipping their deceased ancestors and placing a high value on this practice. The Didinga people live in Budi, country eastern Equatorial State, South Sudan's Didinga's Mountains. They are found throughout the region valleys, neighboring plains and slopes. Economic constraints have caused the Didinga to frequently clash with their neighbors, the Toposa, Boya, Ketebe. Unlike other groups, the Didinga do not practice child marriage or pre-arranged marriages. The prospective pair follows their own sentiments and emotions, and their suitor doesn't approach the bride's parents until after they have decided to get married. Along with three buddies, he is carrying a hua, a spear and six goats when he goes to reveal the affair. Bride price is decided upon and paid for. Divorce is uncommon among the Didinga since infertility is not a reason for divorce. In deep cemetery beyond the town, the deceased are laid to rest, their heads turned toward the east like other neighbors. Currently, cultivation and pursuit of knowledge have equal significance for the Didinga people, as does cow herding. All the Didinga are still ingrained with the customs around cattle raying. Having vast heads still brings immense satisfaction to many people. Their daily lives are still infused with the optimism for changing they discovered during their brief move. In addition to using their cattle as a source of income, the Didinga also use the milk from them to make butter, which is consumed on a daily basis. Didinga also drink fresh blood that is extracted from tiny arrows from the necks of animals. The Didinga people don't fish at all, as it's frowned upon in their culture to eat fish. With expectations of close friends and families, the ladies stay alone in the house for 3 to 4 days after giving birth, depending on whether the child is a girl or a boy. She is prohibited from cooking because it is believed that she is a ceremonial pollutant. It's regarded good luck when twins or triplets are delivered. But their father cannot eat with other people or go hunting or to fight with any group of people until the triplets are old enough. Please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Thank you for watching.